The United States Navy is investing heavily in the next generation of both helicopter-capable amphibious assault ships and nuclear-powered aircraft carriers. These future vessels represent the strategic backbone of U.S. maritime power projection into the 2030s and beyond. The LHA-class ships are optimized for rotary-wing and short takeoff vertical landing aircraft, while the CVN-class carriers are built for full-spectrum fixed-wing air dominance. Together, they reflect a dual emphasis on flexibility and global reach in increasingly contested maritime environments. The USS Bougainville LHA-8 is the first Flight 1 America-class amphibious assault ship to reintroduce a well deck for launching amphibious craft while maintaining a robust aviation capacity. Scheduled for delivery before 2026, she was christened on December 2, 2023. She represents a return to hybrid amphibious capability after her predecessors focused purely on aviation. Her design balances aviation power and sea-to-shore flexibility optimized for helicopters, tilt rotors, and the F-35B. Her island structure is modified for improved flight deck access and better aircraft flow. She is built by Huntington Ingalls at the Ingalls Shipbuilding Yard in Mississippi. Once commissioned, she will expand the Navy's expeditionary reach in the Indo-Pacific and Mediterranean. The inclusion of a well deck allows for more flexible beach landing operations. With a displacement over 45,693 tons and a length of 844 feet or 257 meters, she closely resembles a light aircraft carrier. The USS Fuja LHA9. She builds directly upon Bougainville's design, introducing upgraded survivability systems and more robust electronic warfare defenses. Construction began in 2023, with delivery expected around 2028, and she is named after the pivotal Iraq War battle honoring Marine sacrifice. She retains the LHA-8 design model, including the restored well deck for amphibious operations. Her systems are hardened to operate in highly contested environments and improved radar and C-41SR resilience. She carries the same aircraft suite, CH-53Ks, MV-22s, and F-35Bs, but with better support for high sortie rates and faster turnaround. Her internal fuel and ordnance handling systems are redesigned for increased safety and operational tempo. Fuja is likely to support early integration of unmanned aviation and logistics platforms. She is also expected to include cybersecurity enhancements and pre-wiring for future command and control tech. As part of the Distributed Maritime Operations Doctrine, she is equipped to function more autonomously than earlier LHAs. The USS Helmond Province LHA-10. This is the third Flight 1 America-class ship and was officially named in 2024 to honor Marine operations in Afghanistan's Helmand Province. Construction is expected to begin by 2026 and commissioning likely in the early 2030s. USS Helmand Province will be the most future-ready of the America-class Flight 1 ships, leveraging the longest design window for advanced technologies. She will be structurally similar to her predecessors, but upgraded to support unmanned systems across air, sea, and potentially surface domains. She is expected to feature enhanced automation and maintenance, AI-assisted battle management, and pre-installed systems for directed energy weapons. Her aviation infrastructure will be capable of launching both manned and unmanned platforms at scale, including next-generation VTOL drones. Her radar and sensor suites will reflect the latest in threat detection and electromagnetic warfare shielding. Once deployed, she will be forward operating force multiplier in pure conflict and humanitarian scenarios alike. The USS Enterprise CVN-80. This will be the third four-class carrier and is named after one of the most storied ships in U.S. naval history. She is under construction at Newport News Shipbuilding, with a launch expected in November 2025 and commissioning by 2029. As the first four-class carrier fully designed using digital engineering tools, she benefits from improved structural integration and streamlined systems. She will feature advanced electromagnetic launch, arresting gear and high-capacity power generation for future tech. Her layout is optimized for increased flight operations tempo and improved crew habitability. She will host a carrier wing including F-35Cs, E-2D Hawkeyes, and MQ-25 Stingray drones. Enterprise will be flagship for advanced training, deterrence patrols, and power projection in the Indo-Pacific. She is designed to reduce manpower costs through greater automation and predictive maintenance systems. With modular electronics and weapons handling systems, she will remain upgradable for decades. Enterprise will be a symbol of digital era naval dominance with a 50-plus year. The USS Doris Miller CVN-81. This is the fourth Gerald R. Ford-class aircraft carrier named after a World War II hero and Navy Cross recipient who broke racial barriers. She is scheduled to be laid down in January 2026, launched on October 2029, and commissioned in 2032. She will carry forward the innovations of Enterprise, but with even more refined system automation and upgraded propulsion control. Doris Miller will be the first Ford-class carrier built from the start to support manned-unmanned teaming, MUMT, operations. Her air wing will include advanced drones alongside F-35Cs and future sixth-generation fighters. She will integrate enhanced cyber defense architecture and digital command systems for joint force and coalition operations. Her combat systems and radar suites will be hardened for electronic warfare resilience. She is designed for forward deployment in contested maritime regions, including the South China Sea and Arctic waters. Doris Miller will serve as a powerful symbol of progress and capability in more interconnected naval force. USS William J. Clinton CVN-82. This is a planned Gerald R. Ford-class carrier set for procurement in fiscal year 2030. She is scheduled to be laid down in 2027, launched in 2032, and commissioned by 2036. She will be built at Newport News Shipbuilding in Newport News, Virginia. She was officially named in 2025, honoring the 42nd President's contribution to national security and global diplomacy. Clinton will feature infrastructure for sixth-generation aircraft, larger drone detachments, and energy weapons integration. She will likely include advanced electromagnetic defenses and support for railguns or directed energy systems. With modular AI systems, she will rely heavily on predictive diagnostics and automated threat tracking. Clinton will be built for long-duration deployments with minimal crew fatigue due to enhanced automation. Her role will emphasize deterrence and resilience in pure conflict zones, especially across the Indo-Pacific. USS George W. Bush CVN-83. She is the planned follow-on Ford-class aircraft carrier announced in 2025 and is expected to begin construction after CVN-82. She is named to honor the 43rd U.S. President and will likely serve as either the final Ford-class carrier or a bridge to the next carrier generation. Bush will incorporate the most mature version of EMALS, AAG, and UAV handling systems of any Ford-class ship. She is anticipated to host the Next Generation Air Dominance platform and fully autonomous aviation elements. With advanced materials, she will feature electromagnetic hardening, cybersecure systems, and enhanced internal AI control networks. Bush is expected to operate with reduced crew requirements through robotic systems and distributed decision-making frameworks. She may include provisions for hypersonic missile defense and energy weapons integration. Her mission sets will include high-risk deterrence patrols in the Arctic, Indo-Pacific, and space communications threat environments. She will carry the U.S. Navy's future into the 2080s. With this, We The Buzz is signing off for today, but don't forget to stay tuned as we bring you more interesting videos from the world of military. We'll see you guys again in our next video. Bye-bye.